Hey everyone. Just recently I had the chance to visit New Jersey's Monmouth Battlefield State Park. This park is the site of the Battle of Monmouth. It was fought in 1778 during the Revolutionary War. The most enduring story concerning that battle is the story of Molly Pitcher. Molly Pitcher is most often thought to be Mary Hayes Macaulay, although some historians believe that Molly Pitcher is most likely a character based on stories of several women who were involved in the Revolutionary War. But whether Molly Pitcher is legend or not, Mary Hayes Macaulay was a real person. She belonged to the group of camp followers that traveled with the Continental Army. Mostly women, these camp followers provided support to the troops by cooking, washing, and caring for the wounded. The day that the Battle of Monmouth took place was extremely hot, nearing 100 degrees, and men were dropping from the heat. Mary carried buckets of water from a nearby spring to the troops. The exhausted soldiers would call out, "Molly Pitcher," and the name stuck. Some say that when Mary's husband fell, either from heat exhaustion or from a wound he received in the battle, Mary helped man the cannon. A soldier who fought in the Battle of Monmouth later wrote his memoirs, and in them, he described Molly Pitcher during the battle. A woman whose husband belonged to the artillery and who was then attached to a piece in the engagement, attended with her husband at the piece the whole time. And while in the act of reaching a cartridge and having one of her feet as far before the other as she could step, a cannon shot from the enemy passed directly between her legs, without doing any other damage than carrying away the lower part of her petticoat. Looking at it with apparent unconcern, she observed that it was lucky it did not pass a little higher, for in that case, it might have carried away something else, and continued her occupation. Another legend of Molly Pitcher concerns General George Washington. It seems he was so impressed with Mary's bravery that he issued her a commendation, and she earned another nickname, Sergeant Molly. And with stories like these, of course, Molly Pitcher became a huge draw for all the visitors here to the battlefield. And of course, they wanted to visit the spring where Molly drew her water for the troops. And so did I. And for this, I had to step outside the park. Here is the monument marking Molly Pitcher's spring. It was erected in 1938 by local farmers William Perrine and Alexander Josco. And right next door to it is the spring. But despite the marker, the spring, and the flags and mementos left here by adoring tourists, this is not the spring. Never was. But they say these farmers made a little money selling water to tourists who wanted to get a little taste of the Molly Pitcher legend. Now just down the road is another Molly Pitcher spring. Really, this one's more of a well. And there used to be a sign here that said, Molly Pitcher's Spring. That sign is now gone, and that's probably for the best, because this is not Molly Pitcher's Spring either. See, the railroad built this well with the full knowledge that this was not the right spot. They built it to keep curiosity seekers from crossing the track in search of the real well. And as you can see, these tracks are still active. Now, just a short walk up the road from the well is a sign claiming that Molly Pitcher's spring is in a well next to the house just northeast of here. And apparently this is not the spring either, because the house just northeast of here would have been between the two opposing forces. Not a safe place to be drawing water for the troops. But today, there is a new best location for Molly Pitcher's spring. And many historians agree on this location. So I went to the Perrine Hill section of the park in order to find it. After a while wandering the fields, I came across this marker, the Great Cannonade. And considering that Molly once manned the cannons, this was an encouraging sign. And a little further on in a small clearing, I found this marker, Mary Molly Hayes, pay dirt. This is the newest and latest, based on the best historical information, Molly Pitcher Spring. So I stood there on the viewing platform for a little while, and I searched for the spring in the woods below me, but I didn't find it. It could be a seasonal spring, I don't know, but I'm going to take it on faith that it's there somewhere. Because it's really not the spring, it's the Molly Pitcher story that counts. And one day this spring might be like the other springs, an old spring that used to be believed was Molly Pitcher's spring, but new historical evidence will come up and they'll decide that the spring is really somewhere else on the battlefield here. And that's okay. Thanks for watching. To you when I die.